Life for the mentors. Tell somebody, life for the mentors. So today we are going to see some life fundamentals for our fathers. What our fathers can do to make their family successful. We are going to see that today. Fundamental is forming a foundation to build your life on. What foundation can we form as a father to build our family on? What foundation can we form as a father to help our children to succeed? So that is what we are going to see today. But before we go into that, if you are here today and you have not given your life to Christ, take a step today and give all to Jesus Christ. If you are in the congregation today, you have not given your life to Christ, or you are a father today, you have not accepted Christ truly as Lord and Savior, it's very important that we do that today, not tomorrow. Everything that I'm going to tell us today to form a good, solid foundation for our family, let us try as much as possible to begin to apply them into our lives today. Tell somebody today, not tomorrow. It is today, not tomorrow. Everything you are going to hear, what you have been hearing, any instruction given to you pertaining to your life to form a good foundation, let us begin to implement them. When? Today, now. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 15. As thus been said, today, if you hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as you did in the rebellion. Anytime we are telling you to give your life to Christ, anytime a message is coming to you to make changes into our lives, let us do that, those changes today, because tomorrow might not be there. Tomorrow might be too late. 2 Corinthians 6:2. For he says, in an acceptable time I have heard you, and in the day of salvation, I have helped you. Behold, now is this accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. When is the day of salvation? This is the time we should give our life to Jesus Christ. This is the time, today is the time we should decide what to do with our lives. This is the time we should decide what to do with our family. Because tomorrow might not be there. Tomorrow might be too late. Today is the day of salvation. Today is the acceptable day to make changes in our family. Today is an acceptable day to make changes in our lives, for especially for fathers, to be a good father, to be a responsible father. Today is the time. Why now you should not ask me? If I say today, don't ask me why now, because there are so many reasons why we have to do it today. Look at James chapter 4 from verse 13. James 4 verse 13 said, do not boast about tomorrow. Verse 13 says, come now, you who say, today or tomorrow, we will go to such and such a city, spend year there, buy and sell, and make a profit. Verse 14, whereas you do not know what will happen tomorrow. For what is your life? It is a vapor that appears for a little time and then vanishes away. Instead, you ought to say, if the Lord wills, we shall live and do this or that. We must not just say, oh, live a life of presumption, that, oh, I presume I can still be here 40 years. So I can live those things, I can take care of those things, maybe 10 years' time. We should not say that. And I want to conclude this introduction with this story. This is what really happened to somebody. And we should buy from this mistake this person made. And I want to read verbatim. The Associated Press ran the story of Andre Francois Raffray. Wrote a story about Andre. 30 years ago, at the age of 47, I want you to follow me with this, please. At the age of 47, he worked out a real estate deal with Jane Calmet. It was a real estate deal. Jane was then 90 years old. Remember, Andre was 47 years old then. So he worked a deal with Jane. He would pay her $500 each month until her death in order to secure ownership of her apartment in Paris, France. This is a common thing they do in France. So I pay until you die. Then when you die, I take over your property. And the real estate people have been making money through this. But this one is different. This is a common practice, but it's different to this one. Unfortunately for Ravi, Jane Kamet has become the world's oldest living person. She became the world's oldest living person. This is real life situation. Still alive at age 122. Still alive at age 122. She outlived Rafre. She outlived Rafre, who died in December 1995 at the age of 77. Rafre died at the age of 77. He had a deal with this lady, this old lady, at the age of 47, while that lady was 90 years old. Look at life presumption. You will have assumed that that lady will die before him. He paid $184,000 for an apartment he never lived in. It was a deal. He has to keep the commitment. According to the contract, Rafre survivors must continue to must continue payment until Mrs. Kamet dies. If they stop the payment, then the contract is null and void. So don't live a life of presumption that, oh, I can see a group here. When you have opportunity to make changes about issues of your life, do it today. If you're a father here and you have been found wanting, you have been lacking in taking care of your family, don't say until I get money. The little money you have now, be committed to your family. Amen. Life fundamentals for our men. I want to give some of these fundamentals I put down here. One, Father is the head of the family, as Christ is the head of the church. You are to lead your family the way to go in all things of life. You are the first pastor your family must know. Amen? Fathers, are you listening to me now? You are the first pastor your family must know. Ephesians 5:23. For the husband is the head of the wife, as also Christ is the head of the church, and he is the savior of the body. So, you are the head of the family. Proverbs 22 from verse 28. Proverbs 22 from verse 28. Do not remove the ancient landmark which your fathers have set. Do you see a man who exerts in his work? He will stand before kings. He will not stand before unknown men. You must excel in being a pastor of your family. As a father, you must excel in leading your children right. As a father, you must excel in getting yourself committed totally to your family. Look at what God said about Abraham. For I have known him. Genesis 18, verse 19. This was when Sodom and Gomorrah was in big trouble. So the angels visited Abraham. Look at what the Lord said about Abraham. For I have known him, in order that he may command his children and his household after him, that they keep the way of the Lord to do righteousness and justice, that the Lord may bring to Abraham what he has spoken to him. The Lord should be able to say about you that I have known him. He will lead his children the way of the Lord. He will encourage them to serve the Lord. He will encourage them to keep the rightful way of the Lord. The Lord should be able to say that about you. God is taking notice of everything. The Lord should be able to say that you put God first in every issue of your life. You put God first when it has to do with the issue of your family. You put God first and you encourage them to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, so the Lord shall have to eat anything whatsoever you lack. Praise the Lord. Number two, fundamentals. One of those fundamentals that we should know. Number two of these fundamentals. Any man who fails to work at his relationship or marriage or family often have the roughest ride on the back roads of family. If you don't work on your relationship, if you don't work things out with your wife, if you don't work things out with your children, you have a very rough path on the roadmap of family. Very important. I'm talking to fathers now. I think I'm talking to Christian fathers. I'm talking to the follower of Christ. If you as a man, if you fail to work, continuously work on your relationship, continuously work on the relationship of your children, continuously work on your family, if you don't do that, you will have a roughest ride on the back roads of family. Number three, fundamental. Building a family is like building a house. Like a good house, a good family does not just happen. It has to be built. Look at a rose. If a rose is so beautiful, do you think the rose just become beautiful like that? Somebody planted it. Somebody put water. Somebody make everything good to make the rose beautiful. If you want your wife to be beautiful, you got to do all the necessary things. If you want your children to be great, you got to do the necessary things. If you want your family to be wonderful, you have to make sure you get committed, put the water, nourish, get invested, invest things into your family. Amen. Number four, for a house to be strong, it must be built for strength. So you have to build your family for strength. Your family as a house, you as the head of the family, as a man, you have to build for strength. We can either build for beauty or we can build for strength. The West always build for strength. Build your family for strength. Build the man at the head of the family. Protect the family. Make sure the family is totally in good hands. Praise the Lord. The next number. If you focus on finding a solution, you end up as a friend and not as enemy. If you focus on finding solution for the issues of your family, you become a friend of your wife. You become a friend of your children, not an enemy. But if you don't focus on finding solution, you'll be a serious monster for your family, your children, or your wife. Next one, a good father should be generous. Tell somebody, a good father should be generous. You should be generous of your time. You should be generous with your money. You should be generous with anything God has given you to take care of your family. A good father must be generous. But look at this. Not all fathers are generous. Stinginess kills a relationship. When you are stingy, it can kill your family. Stinginess kills a relationship. Relationship and family life are based on unselfish giving. You got to give as a man, as a father. You have to give selfishly. Unselfishly. You have to give. You got to put your family first, and yourself will come next. If you stop giving, you destroy love. If you want your love between your wife to get destroyed, or your children to get destroyed, stop to give. Try it for 1 year. Stop to give everything. Try it. That you know that this is a good fundamental. When you stop to give, you do what? You destroy the whole system. If you stop giving, you destroy love. If you want to celebrate your partner, or you want to celebrate your family, you have a milestone you want to celebrate, and you take them to Burger King, what do you think is happening? Because you are stingy. Say, hey, honey, I love you. Let us celebrate your 48th birthday. And then you go to Burger King. Stinginess kills love. It's not every time. That is the time you must be able to do what? Spoil her a little. Spoil her what? Honey, where do you want to go? Children, where do you want us to go? Children, they know, they are very current. They know the best place to go. When they tell you, let us go there, don't say, hey, I don't have money now. No, that is too late. If you don't want them to give you answer, don't ask them. Let me give you this illustration. Commitment to our family is so fundamental. Commitment to the one you love is so fundamental. If you are a father and you love your family, you got to be committed. Let me give you this story. This is a real life story. Families don't grow unless parents invest precious time in them. Families will not grow except parents will invest precious time. In Newman, Gary Oliver writes, about a difficult decision made by professional baseball player Tim Bulk concerning his family. From the time Tim can first remember, his dream was to be a professional baseball player. Talking about Tim now, you can Google about Tim, popular baseball player. But look at what happened to him. Through years of sacrifice and hard work, he achieved that goal. And how did he achieve it? While a successful pitcher for the Montreal Expos, he and his wife wanted to start family, but discovered they were unable to have children. So what did Tim do? After much prayer, they decided to adopt 4 special needs international children. Adopted children now. But look at the sacrifice. This led to one of the most difficult decisions of Tim's life. He discovered that his life on the road conflicted with his ability to be a quality husband and dad for his 4 adopted children. Over time, it became clear that he couldn't do a good job at both. So he had to sacrifice something. After more prayer and soul searching, he made what many considered an unbelievable decision. He decided to give up a professional baseball. You know what that means? Giving up money. Ego. When he left the stadium for the last time, reporters wanted to know why he was retiring at the prime of his profession, with millions of dollars awaiting him. He decided to retire. This is what Tim said. Baseball is going to do just fine without me. He said, it's not going to miss a beat, but I am the only father my children have. I am the only husband my wife has, and they need me a lot than baseball does. You got to put your family first. Some of us, we keep saying, I'm a good dad. You are not around. They don't see you. When you are needed, you are financially, you are not there. Time, you are not there. My children know that I'm very nice. Why are you nice? If you are in a situation to give up your family or to give up dollars, which one are you going to give up? Which one are you going to sacrifice? Some call fathers, they are ready to sacrifice their family because of dollars. You can always make money. But let me tell you the truth, when it has to do with the issue of family, it's time. And once that time passes, you cannot recover that time pass back. Think about this. For you to be a successful father, you must form a good partnership and solid relationship with your wife. You cannot be a good father without this. You can ask me, to be a good father, you need your wife. To be a good father, you need that mother, the mother of those children. You need to work with her. To be a good father, you cannot do it alone. You cannot leave her alone to do it either. Most of the problem we have in this society, watch out, is just because some fathers are runaway fathers. Some, they want to enjoy everything that has to do with family, but they don't want to have family per se. Most of the phone calls today, the highest phone calls today is to prison yard. Most of the fathers, they are on the street, they are in prison now because they do not want to walk hand in hand with their wives. And so they got into trouble. You cannot do it alone. Fundamentally, you need your wife. You need the mother of those children to be a successful father. Even when you have the money, when you have everything, you still need the counsel of your wife. Now I'm telling you what I know. This is not what somebody told me. I met my wife now about 32 years ago. So I'm not joking. And now we've been married for almost 28 years now. It's over 27 years. So I'm not joking. I know what I'm talking about. Most time, when you see me, you see my wife, so that I don't get into trouble. Most places I go with my wife. I am ready to showcase her. She's the best Miss Universe. Hello. That is what God has given me. I have no regret. Some of us, we regret, we are regretting marrying that woman. We are regretting that family. I would have had a good family. That is the best family God has given you. That is the best wife God has given you. That is the best mother of your children. Honor her. Respect her. Seek her counsel so that your days may prosper. So that your days may be peaceful. Do you understand me now? You want to be a successful father? Don't say stay with your wife. It's making it so boring. Amen? Teamwork is very important, fundamental thing you should know. Teamwork. I told you before, the reason why snake is very easy to kill snake. Hunters, they don't have problem to kill snake because it's the only one. Can you imagine if they work men in group? If snake is walking and all the children are coming behind and the grandchildren are coming and the great-grandchildren are coming, the uncle coming, the niece coming, do you think it's going to be easy for a hunter to kill snake? But snake is always alone. Don't be a lone ranger. Hydrogen. The Lord will bless you in Jesus' name. I'm talking to Christian fathers now. Amen. I'm talking to Christian fathers. Have quality friends. Don't have friends that will tell you things that will go back and hurt your family. You have a friend, they telling you negative, negative, negative about your family, you better keep that friend afar. Amen? Teamwork. To be successful as a father, you need your wife to work with you. And you know, the Bible is so clear about that. Look at Genesis 2, verse 18. And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. Your wife is your helper. To be a father, you know, if you say, no, I don't need her. I can be the best father without my wife. Then you are saying that God is not right. God is wrong. Because God is saying, you as a man, you as a father, even if you are going to be a potential father, it is not good for you to be alone. Are you listening to me now? I hope I'm not going to be in trouble. Proverbs 18:22. He who finds a wife finds a good thing and obtains favor from the Lord. I'm talking about fathers now. Fathers, fathers, fathers. That the mother of your children is a good thing you have received. And it's a favor. It's a favor. You have a great favor to have a woman who loves you. To have a woman who's ready to carry your baby for 9 months. It's what? Clap for our mothers. Clap for our mothers. Clap for our mothers. They are good. 1 Corinthians 11:9. 1 Corinthians 11:9. It says, nor was man created for the woman, but woman for the man. A woman is created for the man. So, if I say now that it's not good for you to be alone, say, I can be alone, I can make it without her. Forget about that. Now you are saying it's just like you want to travel from Chicago. That's where I'm talking from now. You want to travel from Chicago and you are going to London. And somebody told you, no, I will get you a flight. I will get you a free flight to go. You say, no. I don't want a free flight. I'm going to trek. First and foremost, you can't trek Atlantic. That is the first thing. Second thing is, if you say the next option will be to go by ship or by whatever, it's going to take you weeks to get there. So why can't you take the best offer just to fly to London from Chicago, maybe about 9 hours in the air, right? You are there instead of being weeks on the sea, or you want to trek the impossible. So when God says, don't be alone, you need an helpmate. Say, I don't need an helpmate. You are trying to say that I can do it myself, and then I can face the consequences, and I can take it the hard way. The hard way is not the best way. So for this cause, God said it's not good for you to be alone. A woman has been created for you. You are not created for her. She was created for you so that she can help you to carry your burden. She's a burden bearer. And they are very good at doing that. Tell somebody, I thank God for mothers.
I thank God for myself.
I know it is Father's Day. But do you think I'm going to be here without my mommy? Without my mother? Do you think I'm going to be here? So far, so good. We got to be in their womb to come out here. There are some of those things that we can apply into our lives as father to make everything great. Let me just say some of those things and we're going to pray. I know time is far spent. Communication. We should try to communicate with our partners. Some of us, the worst thing that we are doing is that instead for us to communicate and resolve issues, we just keep quiet. Everything we bottle up, and then before you know it, you can't continue to bottle everything. It will get to a state when everything is going to burst out. Communication. Talk to her, sit down with her, understand her, try to know how she reasons, understand your family, know what your family needs, know how to take care of your family. You can do it. Even if you are still facing some challenges now, it's a matter of time. It's seasonal. Maybe there's a little separation right now. God knows everything. It's seasonal. If genuinely in your heart, you are ready to sacrifice something to make your family better, and that's what you are doing, God knows, and God is going to help you. He's a present help in trouble. God is going to help you. Look, the eyes of the Lord is looking everywhere, through and fro, to show himself strong on behalf of those whose hearts are perfect towards him. If you want to follow the God's own will, the Lord will help you. He will see you through. He will bless every work of your hands. But if you say you want to go the other way, it's a curse. To go the other way. It's a curse. Communication, in other words, is the only means by which two people become one. Communication is the only means whereby you as a man, you can be successful. Communicate. Some of us, we resolve everything all alone. We logically resolve everything. We think alone. We think, and if you get to say, whereby you'll be talking, and while you are sleeping, your wife will say, "Why? What are you thinking?" You took the thinking, or the reasoning when you are not sleeping. You take it to your dream, and you are doing it all alone. Instead, for you, there is a woman with you, full of wisdom that God has given you, who is ready to help you. You can't discuss with her. Why? Trust. Another fundamental is that we must trust each other. Amen? If you want to be a successful man, you must trust each other. At least a level of trust for your children, a level of trust for the mother of your children, your wife. There must be trust. If there is no trust, it's hard to be a successful father when you need the help of your wife. You must trust her with everything that you have. You must trust her. Do you really trust your family, that your family is able, by the grace of God, to go ahead and do the best? Do you trust the mother of that family? Do you trust that everything you commit to that mother, she will be able to do it right? So let us assume that, praise the Lord, I'm trying to look at my time. Now let us assume that, okay, the foundation we have laid, foundation is very important for family. As a father, the foundation you are laying is very important so that your children can build on this foundation. As a father, the example you are giving is very important so that your wife can follow that example. She's supposed to follow your leadership. Amen? Now let us assume that, okay, mistake has been made. What can we do? Can we go through that before we go? How do you know as a father that foundation of your home is weak? And what are you going to do about that? Now, these are the symptoms of a weak marriage or a weak family or a weak relationship. Amen? These are the symptoms that you should look for. If you are a father, it's very rough now. You are finding it very hard to lead your family. These are the things that must help. And for those of us that maybe you are still planning to have a family, these are the things you look for so that you can form a very good, solid family foundation. This is the first one, that you can see that, oh, this foundation is not proper, it's weak, and we want God to help us. One, when you are with your family, either with your wife or with your children, and you are experiencing these things, then the foundation is weak, and you need to do something, you need to pray, you need to work at it, you need to seek counsel of godly people. You don't want to spend time with your family. You like to spend time outside. You don't want to come home. The foundation is what? It's weak. Two, you constantly have regrets about your family. Oh, this is not, oh God, why did you do me this? Oh Lord, why me? This is not the kind of family I want. The foundation is weak somewhere, and you need to strengthen the foundation. You constantly think or use hard words about your family and say negative things about them, starting from your wife. When you meet your friends, what you are saying about your wife is negative. What you are saying about your family is negative. The foundation is what? It's weak. I am not telling you what I am not doing. I'm telling you the best thing you have to do as a father to be the head of that family, because God is going to ask you. I never sit you down and talking down my wife. It's not going to be. I'm not going to do that. Because when I talk down my wife, I'm talking down myself. I'm telling you the truth. Even if she has done something wrong, I'm going to be praising her. Amen? I'm not going to sit down with you and be telling you that woman. See that woman as you see her? She's an hypocrite. She's a chameleon. What she's doing outside is not what she's doing inside. Some of us, we talk down our family, we talk down our children, we talk down our wives. You are not a good father. Your foundation is weak. You must strengthen your foundation. The only one who can help you is God. You are enduring rather than enjoying your family. I'm just enduring this family. Any small opportunity, you run away. You must not endure. You must enjoy that family. You don't have another family. You want to start all over? I'm very sorry for you. The devil you know is better than the one you don't know. If you want to start over, you don't know what's going to happen with the one you are going to start. You keep secrets from each other. You keep secrets from your family. Some of you, they don't know how much you got in your account. Some of you, they don't know where you are building houses. I learned some are building houses in Japan, they're building houses in Germany, they're building houses in Africa, and their partners don't know. Hey, that is not what? It is not good. What is not good is not good. I hope I will not be in trouble. Let me ask you, fathers, answer me. Fathers, when last time did you laugh with your family? You just create a laugh. There are some fathers, if you look at their eyes, oh, it's fire. It's what?
Fire.
When they are coming from there like this, if you meet them, if you don't take my back, go and sit down. You are like your mother. Come on. What is going on? You are the head of that family. Create fun in that family. Create fun. Let there be good atmosphere. Let love flow in the family. Let peace reign in the family. Let joy flow in the family. Create a structure that will allow the flow of love, the flow of peace, the flow of joy in your family. You are the only one who can do that. No one else is going to do it for you. Are you not a father? Are you not a father? You want me to come and do it for you? I cannot do it for you. I cannot do it for my family and also do it for you. Even if I come to your house, I pray with you. I will not come and sleep in between you and your wife or the same bed. That is not the kind of pastoral work that you want. Amen?
Amen.
Or do you want that?
No.
My wife will not even allow me. My wife will not do what? There will be a time when I finish praying with you, I will go back, you close the door, you can do anything you like with your wife. When I'm monitoring that, something is not right. Some fathers, listen to me now, some fathers, this is how to know your foundation is weak. Some fathers, the only physical contact you have with your family or with your, let me say with your wife, the only physical contact, they play it here, those the little playlet, is where you want sex. All day long, it's like, I'm the father. Don't you listen to the pastor? Pastor said, I'm the head of this family. I am the head, I'm your head. And then you braggado, you did everything. Then when it is night time, you are sleeping together. You say, honey, which, she should ask you, which kind of honey are you asking? Because that honey is looking for something. That honey is doing what? That honey is looking for
honey.
And you know some fathers, as soon as honey is honey, as soon as honey is honey, and then, why are you waking me up? Oh, maybe next time I will not honey now. We should, amen. We should be giving compliments, good compliments for each other. As a good father, give compliments for your children. Give it to your wife. Give them compliments. When they do something good, give it to them. Amen. Once in a while, just, you know, life is filled with so many challenges. Even children, they are facing challenges. They face challenges in their schools. They face challenges everywhere. I mean, people, challenges all over the place. So there must be some compliments to keep the day going. Let me tell you, I can keep going and keep going and keep going. I want to say Happy Father's Day. It is God's purpose for us to be a successful father. It is God's purpose for us to carry the, to be the captain of the boat. It's God's purpose for us to make it great in our family. Be able to sacrifice anything for your family. It's the one God has given you. And everything is timed. There will be a time they will remember you. So what do you think your children will remember you for? What will be the landmarks you will leave down for your children? What is the landmark you leave down? What do you want them to, what do you want to be in their memory about you? A day is coming when you're going to leave them here. What will they say about you as a father? I'm talking to a Christian father. I'm talking to people that are giving their life to Jesus Christ. We have some principles. We have some fundamentals we must follow. And those are the ones I have told you. If you want to take your time, you can peruse the message. You can go back to listen to this message again. I pray that the Lord will help us and we shall not be a failure in our generation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Father, we thank you. We bless you for today. May the Father's Day. I want to bless you for this. That we shall not fail you. You have given us the responsibility as a father to grow. We shall not fail you.
Amen.
You have given us the responsibility as a father to lead our family. Daddy, we shall not fail you.
Amen.
To the promised land, we shall lead our families.
Amen.
To the promised land, Daddy, we shall lead our family.
Amen.
Thank you because I know you are with us. And when you are with us, we're able to do it. Backward never, forward ever. If there's a home that is shaking right now, Father, you can do it. With you, nothing is impossible. Daddy, we pray that you rescue any home that is shaking right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Amen.